Beautiful people, today I'm hoping to talk about something very, very important, FM unit. FM unit stands for Frequency Modulated Radio Transmissions, or as I like to call them, personal microphone. The FM unit is a system that's used by people with cochlear implants, hearing aids, and other hearing devices that will amplify sound. As I've said before, hearing does not necessarily mean understanding, and making sound louder does not necessarily mean understanding. So there's one big misconception that I just want to get out of the way. Just because you increase the sound of something does not necessarily mean the listener will be able to understand what is being said. Now, let's focus on what an FM unit is. The type of FM system that I use is right here. It consists of two parts, the transmitter and the receiver. The transmitter is essentially the microphone. It will capture sound and send it to the receiver. The receiver will then take that sound and transfer it over to my processor. Now, the transmitter is made up of two or three parts. First, right here is the microphone. When you talk, sounds goes into the microphone. The microphone then sends the sound to this little processor thing, I would say. And then from there, it is transferred over to the antenna. The antenna will then send the sound to the receiver. The receiver will transfer the sound to the processor, to the magnet outside, to the magnet inside. Okay? So, the first thing a person wants to do when you have the FM system is, if you have big hair or a big head like me, you want to stretch this out. So, here, you will simply hold this and you will pull. Right? Then you will put it on. However, you don't want it to go down here. When you're holding a microphone, you hold it up here. You don't hold it down here. So, what you want to do now is you want to take this little piece and you want to hold it and you want to pull. Now, remember, you want to be comfortable with the FM unit, because the more comfortable you are, the better quality of sound I will probably receive. So, you don't want to do this. No, you do not want to do this. You don't want to do this either. No. You want to put the microphone at a comfortable length between your voice and the microphone. So, here would be perfect. Another thing I've noticed is that if you put up your collar and you put the microphone underneath your collar, you will be very comfortable because the cord will not rub against your neck if you have a sensitive neck. So, comfortable length, and I am able to receive the sound. It's very important, and I hope you're considerate enough to know that you may not want to have a lot of keychains or IDs or necklaces, because the microphone, which is here, will be rubbing against all this stuff. So I'll be hearing this. That's not really helping me. So try to be a little bit considerate of that. And remember, the microphone is here. So try to keep the area clear without items touching it constantly. Also, try to be aware that you have the microphone on you. So try not to touch it. Some people, they get nervous and they start touching it and playing around with it. But remember, when you touch it, I'm hearing that, and we don't want that to happen. So, When you're talking and you're using the FM unit, it's basically cutting the radius of sound. So right now, I'm only hearing about this much in radian. If you were to talk across from me in this direction, I would not be able to hear that because the microphone is isolating that sound. It's just centering on this. And I am able to do that because the microphone has different channels which allow me to set the limit for the radius of sound that the microphone will be able to capture. So, for sound to get to me, you will talk and sound will go to the microphone, down to the processor, through the antenna. And then, I have something here which I explained before in my How Cochlear Implant Works video. And this here is called the T-mic. It's the microphone for my processor, for my hearing normal processor. I will take it off and I will replace it with the receiver. So I'm taking it off. And now I have the receiver and I'm plugging it in. And we're on the air. So, sound is doing this. It's going from your voice to the microphone, down to the processor, to the antenna. The antenna is sending the signal to the receiver, right here. From the receiver, it's going to the processor, to the magnet outside, to the magnet inside, to the cochlea, to the hearing nerve, to the brain, at the same speed that you're speaking. The only difference in the way the FM system works and the normal way that I hear with my cochlear implant is the sound. Right now, I'm hearing myself so much louder. So much louder. And that's why the FM system is helpful. Because if I was in a lecture hall and you were speaking, and you were pacing around the classroom or the lecture hall or the presentation or what have you, I would be able to hear you as if you were right in my ear talking to me right here the whole time. Again, I want to stress that hearing louder does not necessarily mean understanding speech. It just means that I'm hearing you louder. And other systems are also at play. I will be deep reading. So if you're giving a presentation, even if I have the FM unit and you're turning around and I am not reading your lips, I will have a hard time following. So these are just things to think about. Again, please try to remember not to block the FM transmitter or to play around with it, because I will be hearing so many different sounds and that will be very uncomfortable and distracting. So that's pretty much it. That's how an FM system works, and that's why it's so helpful to have one. If you have any questions, let me know. Bye-bye.